Chapter 1. The Revolving of the Planets. Introducing Heliocentrism. Let's take a moment to rewind the clock, back to a time when people believed the Earth was the center of the universe. This was called the geocentric model, and it held sway for a long time. But then, along came Nicolaus Copernicus, a Polish astronomer, who turned this idea on its head. Copernicus proposed a revolutionary theory, heliocentrism, which said that the Sun is at the center and all the planets, including Earth, revolve around it. It might seem like common knowledge now, but back then it radically changed our understanding of the cosmos. Chapter 2. The Copernican Revolution. A real-world perspective. Imagine you're standing on a spinning carousel. To you, it might seem like the world outside is spinning while you're standing still. That's exactly how people felt about the Earth and the heavens until Copernicus came along. Picture Copernicus patiently observing the sky night after night. He notices that the planets don't just wander around randomly. Instead, they seem to be following a predictable path or orbit around the Sun. Take Mars, for example. If Earth was at the center, then Mars would have to do some pretty strange loops in the sky to account for its motion. But if the Sun was at the center, then Mars would follow a nice, neat, elliptical path. By placing the Sun at the center, Copernicus was able to explain why the planets moved the way they did in a much simpler way. Chapter 3. Overcoming Challenges. From Theory to Acceptance. Now you might be wondering, why didn't everyone immediately accept Copernicus's theory? Well, imagine you've been told all your life that the Earth is at the center of the universe. Suddenly someone says, "Actually, we're just one of many planets revolving around the Sun." It's a hard pill to swallow, isn't it? For many people, it was. Copernicus's theory faced a lot of resistance, even from other scientists. The biggest hurdle was the lack of observable parallax shifts in the stars. These shifts would have been proof that the Earth was moving. But the stars were so far away that these shifts were too small to be seen without telescopes, which wouldn't be invented for another 100 years. Chapter 4. The Legacy of Heliocentrism. Changing Our Perspective Forever. In the face of all these challenges, Copernicus's theory eventually won out. Thanks to the work of later astronomers like Galileo and Kepler, who provided more evidence and refined the theory, heliocentrism was accepted. So next time you watch a beautiful sunset, remember that it's not the Sun moving below the horizon, but the Earth rotating on its axis. And if you ever feel like the world revolves around you, just remember, we're all just planets revolving around the Sun. And there you have it, a journey from an Earth-centered view of the cosmos to the realization that we are part of a larger Sun-centered system. A perspective shift that not only changed science, but also how we perceive our place in the universe. If you're enjoying this journey through the cosmos with me, don't forget to subscribe and join our crew of space explorers. There's so much more to discover. Let's explore the universe together.